Chapter 5 Warm-Up, the Algebra 1 Exponent Review. Our essential question, how do you use properties of exponents? There are several properties of exponents, and we're going to review each one individually. You have these 9 problems for independent practice. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at those. So looking at this problem, first thing I always look for are anything raised to the 0 power. This a is raised to the 0 power, which means that a is now a 1. So everything else is going to be written exactly the way that it was, but I am now going to rewrite every single a to the 0 as 1. Now I observe that this x has a negative exponent, which means the x needs to move. So here's my fraction bar. The x is the only thing moving. The 1 did not have a negative exponent, so he stays where he is. The y did not have a negative exponent, so he is going to stay where he is. X is the only thing that had a negative exponent, so he's the only thing that moves. He was in the numerator. He's going to move down to the denominator, and when he moves, his exponent turns positive. I'm not allowed to have an empty numerator, so my numerator is a 1. Now I just need to simplify my fraction. So I have 1 all over, 1 times y to the 5th times x to the 3rd. It's supposed to go alphabetical. This is x to the 3rd, y to the 5th, and then we're done. Next problem. H is the only thing that has a negative exponent. So H is the only thing that's going to move. So here's my fraction bar. The G stays exactly where it was because the G did not have a negative exponent. The H was in the denominator, now needs to move to the numerator. And when it moves to the numerator, you get a positive exponent. This is all over 1. Now we're going to simplify our fraction. Anything all over 1 is just that numerator. And we need to make sure that this is in alphabetical order. G comes before H, so this is G to the 4th, H to the 6th, and we are done. Next problem down here. This negative exponent is only touching the A. It is not touching this negative sign here. So the negative is going to stay exactly where it was. Here's my fraction bar. The A needs to move. It's currently in the numerator. It's now going to move to the denominator, and when it moves, it gets a positive exponent. Numerator is not allowed to be empty, so it's a 1. So my final answer is a negative 1 all over a to the 2nd power. Next problem. This k is the only thing that has a negative exponent, so only the k is going to move. The negative 4 is going to stay exactly where it was in the numerator. K was in the denominator. It cannot stay there. It's going to move to the numerator, and when it moves, his exponent now turns positive. My denominator is empty, so it's a 1. I need to simplify. Anything all over 1 is that numerator. So my final answer is a negative 4k to the 4th power. Next problem. The r is the only thing that has the negative exponent, so the r is the only thing to move. The 7 is going to stay exactly where it was in the denominator. R was in the numerator, needs to move to the denominator, and when it moves to the denominator, it turns to a positive exponent. Numerator is not allowed to be empty, so it's a 1. I need to simplify my fraction, so this is 1 all over 7r to the 3rd power. Next one. The x is the only thing that has the negative exponent. So the x is the only thing that is going to move. So here is my fraction bar. There was a 2 in the numerator. There was a 3 in the denominator. This x is in the numerator. If it was in the denominator, it would have been connected to the 3. It's currently in the numerator. It can't stay in the numerator because the exponent is negative. So it's going to move to the denominator, and it turns to a positive exponent. There is no way to simplify this fraction, so this is my final answer, and I am done. Next problem. The y is the only thing touching that negative exponent. The 3 is not touching it. If that 3 were to be affected by this exponent, it would have had to have been in a parenthesis. So here's my fraction bar. 3 is currently in the numerator. It stays there because it has no negative exponent. The y is currently in the numerator. It needs to move. Y moves to the denominator, turns into a positive exponent. There is no other way to simplify your fraction, so you are done. Our next problem. I always look for 0 exponents first. Here is my 0 exponent. Anything to the 0 exponent is 1. So this is now 2 times 1 times m to the negative third power, because it was 2 times r times the m's. Now I'm going to look for negative exponents. Here's my negative exponent, and he's the only thing that is going to move. So here is my fraction bar. I had 2 times 1 in the numerator. 2 times 1 is a 2. He stays in my numerator. The m was in the numerator, needs to move to the other side. He moves to the denominator, turns into a positive exponent, and I am done. Our very last problem. The n is the only thing affected by that negative exponent, so he's the only thing that moves. Here's my fraction bar. M was in the numerator. It's going to stay in the numerator because he has no negative exponent. The n was in the numerator. He needs to move to the denominator, and when he moves, you get a positive exponent. So this is my final answer, and I am done.